Hello. They told me jokes are bad, that they shouldn't be your friends. And I always believe that everything is a matter of choice, because I had a choice to stay away from jokes when I had the chance. But they wore masks of deception and slithered themselves into my veins till I couldn't get enough. My name is Hope. I'm 18 years old, and this is a story of how I lost my name. God knows I live. God knows I die. God knows I'm bent, bent, borrow and cry. Purple, brown, black. These are the colors of death. But I've always wondered what death would taste like. When it dribbles over my taste buds, would it be sharp, acidic, and metallic? Or maybe silky smooth and sweet like honey? Music thumps through my body. For a moment, the room looks tilted. I can feel the alcohol running through my veins.
This party is lit, hell yeah!
Take it easy, babe. Help you take a break first.
No, I'm cool.
I take a long sip of the bottle in my hand. A hand grips my shoulder, and when I turn around, I see my pretty friend Shane. Red wine, cheap perfume, and a filthy
pout. Try it, Hope. Trust me, you'll be wanting for more.
I look down and see a girl, white, tiny.
What does it taste like? Like life, and only the best kind.
I didn't remember much of what happened after that night.
Where's the money, slut?
Hey, can you come back next week? I swear I have the cash ready. I'll even have extra. Just give me another week.
You piece of shit!
What makes you think I'll wait another week? I need the money tonight. You pay me, or I hurt your friends. Remember our deal?
You do, shit. There's no reason to be a jerk.
You don't know who you're messing with, kid.
Stop it!
Next Friday, if there be any money by the time we arrive, don't hesitate. You freaking hurt your friends.
Listen to me. Everything will be fine, okay?
I couldn't open my eyes. They were too heavy. But I make out voices. It was looks and Shane's.
So you mean the problem is solved?
Damn straight. Then we just have to stick with a plan. Money wouldn't be a problem, and then we can freely take hits for as long as we want to.
I open my eyes, only to see Luke and Shane inhaling something from a tin foil.
What are you two doing? What are you talking about? And where am I?
Vitamins. How are you feeling, Hope?
You were too drunk to drive last night, and the party ended at 1. So Luke had no choice but to let you sleep in his bed. And you know it's better than taking you home where your parents can find out that you've been smoking and drinking and even taking drugs. Which is a lot worse since they're both doctors. Besides, it's Saturday, Since I gave you some dope last night, which you obviously enjoyed, it wouldn't hurt for you to try more, right?
She's right. We should live a little hope. I mean, it's our last year together in college before we step into the real world. You were always curious about what drugs tasted and smelled like before.
I know what it tastes like now, and she was definitely right. It tastes like the best parts of the world all mixed together, right?
That day was the second time I got introduced to drugs. They told me the best drugs make you forget reality. They make you feel invincible and high and mighty. Like you could touch the sky with your fingertips. Like nobody can bring you down. Because of them, it didn't take long before crystal meth became my new best friend. I grew fond of her in an instant. I never wanted to stop.
Have you been eating right, Hope? You've gotten thinner these days. Are you sick?
Of course not. Just tired of school. We worked on a project yesterday and took hours to finish.
Is there something bothering you, Hope? I can sense there's something wrong. Maybe I should arrange a checkup for you. Tomorrow, maybe.
Really? I'm fine. I'm just stressed and tired. I'll be fine by tomorrow, trust me.
Are your friends good kids?
What do you mean?
Look and shame. Do they smoke, drink, take drugs?
Are you crazy? No, they aren't even to those kinds of things. Why do you even ask?
Good, because my biggest fear is seeing my only daughter ruin her own life before my eyes and knowing there's nothing I can do. Please don't ever let that happen, Hope.
I reassured Mom and Dad. I told them it's okay. But I'm afraid it might have been a little too late.
Oh, hey, look, what's up?
Damn, Hope, you're freaking high.
Want some vitamins?
Actually, I came by to ask for some favor.
Sure, what's up?
The thing is, Shane and I owe a lot of money to some dude, Chris, for the thing we've been getting from him. And I just can't think of anyone having enough wealth but you.
Look, I'm not so sure. I mean, now's not the best time. I blew up all my savings for those drugs Shane's been giving me. And my parents? They don't have that much. My dad's retiring early, and my grandmother just died from cancer.
That's bullshit! Your parents never run out of money. Please, baby, do it for me.
No, even if I'll take their money, they'll still find out. And they'll find out about me. And they'll take me to rehab. And that's the last thing I want. I'm sorry.
Well, are your parents home?
No.
Hope? I know to do something I might regret. Remember last month? I let you get away with your debt. Now's your time to do a bit of sacrifice.
I'm really sorry. Believe me. I would help you in a heartbeat, but I really can't.
The only thing I could do was close my eyes really tight as luck ruined me. I never expected my life to turn out like that. We were just having fun. I was just curious. It was just all about taking risks and living up to expectations. But everything looked so wrong. I wish my parents were there. I wish my friends were different. I wish I listened and stayed away from drugs.
You're selfish, you don't stop.
I'm ready when I cry. I'm ready when I cry. I'm ready when I cry. Don't say you need me, why? You leave like you do it right.
I woke up with an incessant throbbing in my head and all over my body. It was already daylight, but my room looked like nothing happened. But the memories from the previous night were something I could never forget.
Breaking news! 18-year-old guy named Luke Reyes was found dead just this morning in Lincoln Street. A street vendor stated that sometime after 4 in the morning, he heard 4 gunshots, which he concluded was the reason Luke was dead. As of right now, further investigations are still being conducted.
Oh my god, it's Luke!
I was 5 and he was
6. I can't believe the news! He didn't do anything! Why are people so cruel? It's the drugs. It's been steering nothing but trouble since the very beginning. Luke was killed because he was deemed as a criminal for possessing illegal drugs.
I know that. No need to point that out. I just can't believe this is happening right now.
You're in this too. You should watch out.
You're such a jerk. You know that.
No, I'm not. You are. That's why you needed my parents' money from the very beginning. Well, I guess you have to pay the price. And those tears, they aren't even real. Because you and I both know that you're just scared that they'll find you next!
Since our fight, I haven't heard from Shane at all. It was just like she disappeared entirely. I called her phone endlessly, but she just turned it off. We might never be friends again, but I was still concerned for her. And all I could hope is that she was safe wherever she might be hiding that time.
Oh my god!
Body of an 18-year-old girl was found washed up on Boulevard Shoreline. The body was identified as Shane Dizon, a drug user. Further investigations are still being conducted. Stephanie Montgomery reporting.
Shane
and Luke were killed mercilessly for possessing illegal drugs without having enough evidence that they were criminals, without undergoing the legal process. Every day since their deaths, I would wake up to a nightmare. I was on the brink of falling apart, and at some point, maybe I actually did. It was all too much for me to bear that I finally went up to my parents, clueless to the mess I have become, and confessed the truth about everything that happened to me. They were disappointed, but they were more than happy that I finally decided to get out of that sick habit. I was immediately sent to rehab, where I started building a new life, my drug-stained fingertips. White, pink, yellow. These are the colors I see today. In fact, I can make out the whole spectrum. All kinds of different shades and hues and intonations. And it's when I knew that I made the right choice.
And go!
I turned myself in. I gave up the life of a drug user. I repented for my sins, but still, I paid the eternal price.
I'd rather save an angel now.
What has the world become?
I'm a believer, it's chaos. We're our leaders. Oh, I'd rather save an angel now. Ooh.
say